on that point as well, one of the questions that has come in is you refer to owners, but what about tenants? And that would be applicable here as well.
It would, Nikki. So bylaws bind owners and tenants, and there's no reason why a bylaw can't say that a tenant, for example, has to pay a bond to the owners' corporation before moving a pet into the building if they're allowed to do so. There have been some questions coming through on our chat about the rights of landlords to stop tenants keeping pets. And that's a separate issue to what we've been discussing. But just to address it very briefly, under residential tenancy laws in New South Wales, landlords are entitled to prevent their tenants keeping pets in the strata building. So that can, in some cases, overcome the problem that the court case has created for owners that want to live in pet-free buildings. And I gave an owners' corporation in Sydney advice recently about their no pets bylaw, and it was all doom and gloom from me. Your bylaw is not worth the paper it's printed on. You need to change it. You need to deal with this tenant who wants to move a dog into the building. And of course, my advice didn't go down particularly well because the Strata Committee wasn't particularly happy about being told that their no pets bylaw was no good. But what did emerge was that the owner of that apartment didn't want dogs or any pets to be kept in it, like many landlords. And under the residential tenancies legislation in New South Wales, that owner was perfectly entitled to say to his tenant, no pets allowed. And that then was a neat way to deal with the problem. And the Strata Committee was very relieved when they discovered that this owner was on their side and didn't want pets in their apartment.